Quicksort algorithm. Quicksort uses the technique of divide and conquer. So how do you proceed? First we pick an arbitrary element, say pivot element. Over here, in the array which I considered, 26, 33, 35, 29, 19, 12 and 22, let's consider the first element as pivot element. Okay, so now we consider the first pivot element. So now we do the partition in such a way that all the elements to the left of 26 are smaller than 26 and all the elements to the right of 26 are greater than 26. So how do we do that? Okay, let's say we keep a pointer I at 26 and J at 22, that is AI and AJ. So we'll keep searching for an element that is greater than 33 from AI, and at the same time in another loop we'll keep searching for an element which is smaller than 26 from the right side. Okay, so I keeps going in the left to right direction and J keeps going from right to left direction. So whenever I finds an element and J finds an element, we swap the elements such that the number which is smaller than 26 goes to the left and the number which is greater than 26 goes to the right. So after this, at last, when I and J meet, at that moment all the elements to the left will be less than 26 and all the elements to the right will be greater than 36. That time if we interchange the J element with pivot, then we'll be getting the sorted array with 26 in the middle, that is pivot element in the middle, and all the elements to the left as that is smaller than 26 and all the elements to the right greater than 26. So if the that's how it happens. So let's see how that happens. So first I is at 26, J is at 22. So now we'll check for 26. 26 is equal to 26, so what we do is we put I over here. So we found an element 33 that is greater than 26. So we come out of an consider while loop and we go to another J loop. Okay, so now J keep goes from right to left. So now checks for 22. 22 is less than 26, right? So now J is already at an element that is less than 26. So what happens? 33 and 22 get swapped. So here goes 22 and here goes 33. Now again I checks, 22 is less than 26. So now I goes here and 35. Again 35 is greater than 26. So I stops over here and goes to J. Now J. J 33 is greater than 26, so I J goes here, right? So again we found an element 12 that is less than 26. So now again 35 and 12 will be swapped, that is 12 over here and 35 over here. Now again I loop. Now 12 is less than 26, so I increments. Now 29 is again greater than 26, so I stops over here and now J goes here. So 35 is greater than 26, so J decrements. Now 19, so 19 is less than 26, so again the swapping occurs between I and J. So 19 goes here and 26. Now again they check for I equal to 19 which is less than 26, so I goes along with J. Now we found 29 that is greater than 26, so I stops over here, again goes to J. Now J is already greater than 29, so J has to decrement. But when J decrements, that is J goes here, but when J goes here, J will be less than I. So we don't want that to happen. So we'll keep a loop such that I is always greater than J. Now as soon as you know we get an element like J is less than I, or we swap pivot and this one. Okay, so now 19 goes here 26 goes here. Now 26 is the pivot element, and now we found all the elements less than 26 to the left of the array and all the elements to the greater than 26 to the right of the pivot element. So this is the first partition. Now we continue same process recursively. Recursively we'll sort the subarrays, that is we can apply same process to these elements as well as these elements. So as the process continues, the sorting happens. So how do we write it in a program? I already written a main function over here. Over here the main takes some integers as array 8 8 20, and we scanned it, and I gave a quick sort function which takes array as input and taking the lower limit and higher limit. So here when I the array is of n elements, right? So from 0 to n minus 1 will be the limit. Okay, so in quick sort, what do we do? First we need two pointers, that is I and j. So we'll write I comma j. Right, now what we do is we'll give I as the lower one and j as the higher one, right, initially. So it goes like this, I equal to low and j equal to high. Now pivot element, we can take any element as pivot element, but over here we are taking first element as pivot element. So let's go with the first element. I say PIV as the pivot element. So PIV equals I. Right. So when the quicksort function is called recursively, we always want low to be less than high. Right. So when the process recursively, when it continues, at a moment we'll get only one element. Okay, that time low won't be less than high. So we need to do the whole recursion only when low is less than high, irrespective of I and j. So now over here, as we considered, I should be always less than j, right? So now we'll write I less than j. Okay, it has to happen again and again, so we keep a while loop here. Now what we are doing, first we are checking for I. Okay, initially this was the array, right? So what we did is first we kept I over here, and we are incrementing I, checking for an element that is greater than 26, that is pivot element, right? So for that we will write a while loop, while what we need is an element greater than pivot, right? So if we don't find an element greater than pivot, we just keep incrementing I, we ignore the element that is smaller than 26, so because it's in the right position, right? So we write I plus plus, but see, I should all, in some cases when j is always the last position, I might go till the last element, but we don't want that. I should always be less than I. So over here we write I less than I. Now once we find an element I that is greater than 26, now we need an element j, that is aj less than 26, that is the pivot element. So over here I write a loop for j. Okay, we need greater than a pivot. Okay, so I wrote over here, I declared it as PIV. So let's change it to PIV. Okay. Pivot. Okay, so over here j minus minus. So whenever we find an element which is greater than pivot, so it is already in the right position, so we just decrement the j, finding. So the loop continues, and whenever over here we found this thing, right? J is less than I. So we should swap the numbers. Over here we are not supposed to swap the numbers at last. So we should swap the numbers only when I is less than J. When I is less than J, we swap the numbers. Swap. Over here I'm swapping with the address. So I'm using the pointer I, comma, we continue swapping process, and when J will be less than I, we come out of the while loop. Now when we come out of the while loop, what we did last, 26 was over here, 19 was over here. So we swap the pivot element with J, AJ, right? So over here I'll write swap. What do you have to do? AJ and pivot. So AJ and A pivot, right? Done. Now a partition is over. Now what we have to do, we have to apply the quicksort for these elements, then we have to apply the quicksort for these elements. So the recursively the process continues. So now what you have to do, quicksort from this element is low, right? And this element is J minus 1. This is J and this I. So this has to be J minus 1. And then another loop for J plus 1 to I. Right? So I'll write another quick sort. I'm just calling the quick sort. Okay? From quick sort of ARA from low to J minus 1, right? So once it clicks this recursively, this happens recursively, all these elements will be sorted. Okay, now we should sort these elements. For that I'll write quick sort A from J plus 1 to I, right? So this has to do, and I define the swap program like this with address. So let me save the program. So let's execute the program. This is a terminal, gcc quicksort. So here number of elements 1 2, that is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7 elements, right? So number of elements are 7. Now save 26, 33, 35, 29, 19, 12, and 22. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right. So sorted elements are 12, 19, 22, 26, 29, 33, 35. See, the elements are sorted. So this is how the quick sort happens. First, we chose an arbitrary element, pivot element, then we divide it into subarrays, and such that all the elements to the left are less than pivot and all the elements to the right are greater than pivot. Then after we do the partition, we do the partition to the remaining elements recursively. And every time we again also keep the pivot element to the middle. So that's how the sort happens. Thanks for watching.